You might not think that art and engineering go together, but in reality, they complement each other very well. Many things that engineers have put together could be considered art, and many things that artists have done take some serious engineering. But what does engineering have to benefit from artistic skills and thinking like an artist? One example you might have seen in the previous video is sketching, an important way of communicating ideas that might be difficult to do otherwise. Let's take a look at engineering through the eyes of someone who's trying to design something. Let's say you're trying to design a machine that launches a volleyball into the air, something that could be used to help someone practice their volleyball skills when no one else is around. Now, when you first set out to design something that solves a problem, a great first step is brainstorming, or thinking of a lot of different ways to solve that problem. I have some sketches here from the brainstorming session in video 2 of this series. Let's take a closer look at them. These sketches better convey the product idea way better than words can do alone. You see how clear they are and how the idea is conveyed really quickly just by taking a quick look? Something like this doesn't have to be perfect or take a long time either. This type of sketching is sometimes called ideation sketching. There are a few basic pointers that can help you get started making your own sketches. So the basic motions for sketching actually come from your entire arm, not just your hand alone. So the first kind of warm-up exercise that we're going to go through, the first basic sketching technique, is the curved line. So to do a curved line, what you want to do is hold your wrist locked, and you kind of want to pivot your whole arm about the elbow. So by using this pivoting motion, you can kind of get a curve shape. So after you practice the curved line motion, or the arc, the next important sketch move is going to be the straight line. So for a straight line, you want to take the motion that you had before, kind of take that arc motion, but you also want to add a little bit of lateral motion. And in that way, you can kind of get something that comes out more straight. So that's how you get lines like this. Some things to pay attention to. If you notice that your lines are a little bit too wiggly, you might be going a little bit too slow. A lot of this sketching is really fast and loose and kind of bold, so you don't want to have too many wiggly lines. Okay, once you've practiced straight lines for a while, the next basic shape is to do some circles. The way to do a circle is you kind of hold your hand over the page, you hold your pen over the page, and without touching down, you make a few practice circles. And then, as soon as you're ready, you kind of touch down and make a circle shape. And that's how you can get something that's pretty round. Now you can draw your circles around a couple times to kind of calibrate. And that's how you can kind of fine-tune your circles. So practice these skills and use them as a way to warm up when you're ready to do some sketching. And if you practice these basic shapes, you'll be better at putting them together to get more complicated shapes and to build up more complicated drawings. Computer software can be used to help in different ways as well. Now, on the technical side of engineering, computer-aided design software, or CAD software, can be used to figure out the exact dimensions of your designs and also to have a precise visual model. One example shown here is called SolidWorks, a common engineering design tool. This can be an extremely effective tool for figuring out the placement of special features in your design, such as holes, and making sure several parts fit together exactly. There are also tools that are usually associated with art and graphic design, such as Adobe Illustrator and Photoshop, which are commonly used in engineering, specifically product design. By using these tools, one can better show others what the intention of their design is. This can be useful for communicating to other designers and engineers, as well as to potential customers and users of your product.
A special type of designer, called an industrial designer, understands the importance of visual communication, An industrial designer uses knowledge of sketching and engineering to carefully design how people interact with products, how they look, and how they're used. Industrial designers specialize in many of the techniques shown in this video.
Hopefully now you're excited about all the different things you can do with your hands, with a pen, and maybe with a computer mouse too. Keep practicing your sketching, and you'll be a better designer in no time.